Hello friends, welcome to Civil 3. In this video we are going to see about some important MCQs of building materials, especially in the topic of timber. These MCQs are repeatedly asked in all the AE and JE exams, especially in IAS exams also. We already know building materials covers more than 10 to 15 marks in all the AE and JE exams, especially the topic timber covers 2 to 3 marks in all the AE and JE exams. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram, join our WhatsApp group and Telegram channel by using the link that is given in the description. The first question is, which one of the following is not endogenous? Option A, deodar; B, bamboo; C, palm; D, cane. The first option, deodar, is the correct answer. What is mean by endogenous? If the tree grow towards inward means it is called endogenous. Exogenous means if the trees grows outwards means then it is called exogenous. The crack in the form of cup shakes which cover the entire annual rings are called ring shake. If hot shake means the cracks or the splits in the center starting from the plate and extend in the direction of the medullary rays and in one or more direction towards the sapwood. Starch shake means these are the cracks or the splits extended from the bark towards the sapwood. And radial shake means these are similar to the starch shakes but occur due to the exposure to sun when fallen timber is placed for seasoning. Once again I repeat, hot shake means it is starting from the plinth and extending in the direction of the medullary rays. Starch shake means it is from extend from the bark towards the sapwood. It is same as that of the star shake but it is caused due to the seasoning. Ring shake means it is a rupture of tissues in the circular direction across the cross section of a log. A good preservative effectively penetrates at least for a depth of 6 to 25 mm. To make the timber fire resistant, antipyrites are used to contain salts of ammonium, boric salts and phosphoric salts. These three salts are used as a fire resistant and antipyrites. To preserve the timber from the white ants, which one of the following is most suitable? And the answer is solignum paints. The veneers are generally used for making plywood, batten boards, laminated boards, and the answer is all the above. The time of seasoning of the moderately refractory timber of 25 mm thickness is, and the answer is 10 days. Now we are going to see about what is mean by seasoning and the types of seasoning and why the seasoning is required. First, what is mean by seasoning means it is the process of drying out the timber to the moisture content approximately equal to average humidity of a situation where it is to be used. Why the seasoning is required means if we fell the new tree means it contains more than 50% water and sap. We want to remove the water and sap. If we didn't remove the water and sap means it leads to decay. In order to prevent the timber from the decay, we are removing the water and sap. How the water and sap is removed? It is removed by means of seasoning. There are two types of seasoning. First one is natural seasoning and the second one is artificial seasoning. In the natural seasoning, there are two types of one marks we can expect. The first one is above which centimeter from the ground the timbers are placed in a horizontal or vertical manner. Above 30 cm of the ground under a curved shed, the timber is stacked whether horizontally or vertically. And the second one markers, for every 25 cm thickness of sawn timber, softwood takes about 2 to 3 months and hardwood about 12 months for seasoning. These are the very important two MCQs which is repeatedly asked in the natural seasoning. And the artificial seasoning means there are number of types of artificial seasoning. Let's we discuss. Now we are going to see about what is mean by artificial seasoning. The first one is water seasoning. In this type, the newly fallen timber is kept in the period kept for a period of 3 to 4 weeks in the water and the sap get removed. In boiling and the steaming, the newly fallen timber is kept in the boiled water for more than 3 to 4 hours. That alone is here 3 to 4 weeks, here 3 to 4 days. Next, clean or hot seasoning. In this type, this type is used for all the types of timber, because if the timber contains excess sap or sap means if the, this type of seasoning is preferred. In this method, timber can be seasoned to any moisture content and hence it is adapted for the rapid seasoning of timber on a large scale. In this process, timber is stacked inside the chamber and hot air is forced for free circulation for about 3 days. Here 3 to 4 weeks, here 3 to 4 hours, here 3 days. Next one is chemical or salt seasoning. In this type of method, the timber is immersed in a solution of suitable salt which absorbs the moisture content from the inside the timber. Next one is electric seasoning. It is an established fact that the green timber offers less resistance to the flow of electric current as compared to a dry timber. And the next one is that means resistance is inversely proportional to the moisture content. Next one is smoke drying. In this method, timber is dried over a fire of straw or finger. Next one is charring or scorching. In this process, the ends of the piles of the post are burned to a charcoal in order to remove the moisture content. In water seasoning, it is immersed in water for more than 4 weeks. In boiling, the timber is exposed to the boiling for more than 3 to 4 hours. In clean or hot air seasoning, the timber is exposed to the hot air for more than 3 days. In chemical or salt seasoning, the timber is immersed in a solution of table salt which absorbs the moisture content. Electric seasoning, the current electric resistance is passed to a timber. Smoke drying means over a fire or straw of pig. Charring or scorching means it is burned to become a charcoal. From that the seasoning is done. Thank you for watching our video. For more videos, subscribe our channel. Join our WhatsApp group and Telegram group by using the link that is given in the description. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram. We are conducting quizzes in Facebook, WhatsApp, Telegram and Instagram. Join, attend the quizzes and enrich your knowledge in both aptitude and civil engineering.